Wisconsin. Unfortunately, some of my video files were corrupted, so I decided to recreate the appetizer portion of our video. The first one I'm going to make is chicken and shallot pastry cups. I'm going to thinly slice some shallots. This is for the chicken puff pastry cups. And the reason I like to use shallots instead of onions, they're a little milder, so they're not going to overpower the chicken, because chicken also is a kind of mild protein. And so I think the combination will be delicious. I'm going to go ahead and slice these all up nice and thin. Be back in a sec. So I've got the shallots and I'm sauteing them in some butter. This is one recipe where you don't want to use olive oil for this, because this is going to be part of a filling and we want it to be rich and satisfying. So we're going to let those go for a bit. We're not going to quite caramelize them, but we are going to get them quite soft. I've got one chicken breast that I've split, and I'm going to go ahead and saute this. I'm just going to salt and pepper both sides. I've already done the first side. And we're going to give this a little bit of olive oil. And I'm going to saute these. They aren't going to get completely cooked through, because after I saute them on both sides, I'm going to chop them up into smaller pieces and then put them back in the pan. So we're going to go ahead and get those started. So you can see I've just got a little bit of oil in the pan. This is a great nonstick pan, but I like the little bit of flavor that olive oil adds as well. So I'm going to go ahead and saute these on both sides and then remove them from the heat and cool them before I cut them up. I finished sauteing the chicken. I took it off the heat and let it cool, and then I diced it up pretty fine, because these are going to be little appetizers and I don't want great big chunks of chicken hanging out of the puff pastry. And to this I'm going to add a little bit of sherry. Now, if you don't have sherry at home or you don't like it, you could add Marsala wine or even some good white wine. So I'm going to go ahead and saute off the alcohol. I'm also going to add just a little bit of chicken stock, and you can see I had chicken juices already in there from the saute. And I'm going to turn this up pretty high, because I really just want to reduce that sherry. I don't want to cook this all the way through even yet, because these are going to go in the oven and I don't want dry chicken. So we're just going to cook that down real quickly and then move on to the next step. I've taken the chicken off the heat. You can see that most of the sauce is cooked down. I'm not going to pour that out. That little bit will just mix in with everything else for the filling. So we're going to go ahead and put that in our bowl. And then we're going to add our sauteed shallots. Now, they're not quite caramelized, but they are very soft. I'm not going to use all of these. I'm going to go ahead and mix that together. This is sort of a French-themed appetizer with puff pastry. So I've got some fresh thyme and a little bit of dried tarragon. I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle that in. You could make this Italian and use some basil and oregano or some powdered rosemary. I wouldn't suggest fresh, because it's not going to cook very long and those would just still be hard. And then to this we're going to add a half a cup of shredded Parmesan. I know that's not French, but they didn't have any good French grating cheeses at the store, so I went with this. And we're going to mix this all together, and you can see it's absorbed all of that liquid. And then we're going to set this aside and prepare our pastry cups. I forgot to say, add a little bit of salt and pepper. Not too much because you've already salted them before you cooked it. And there is cheese in it, but just a little bit extra for flavor. So I'm gonna go ahead and stir that in and then get going on the pastry cups. For the pastry cups, you can make them two different sizes. If I'm doing it for the family, for a nice light dinner, I tend to use regular muffin pan. But when I'm using them for a party as appetizers, I like to use my mini. So we're gonna go ahead and spray the pan. I've got a sheet of puff pastry. I've let it come to room temperature. I'm gonna lay down just a little bit of bench flour so this doesn't stick. And all we're gonna do is roll it out a little bit thinner than it comes in the package. So just get rid of the papers, and I'm gonna go grab my rolling pin. I like my middle rolling pin because it doesn't stick very much. And I'm just gonna take my time and roll this out till it's just a little bit bigger. That way we'll have a nice thin pastry cup instead of a thick and chewy pastry cup. So I'm gonna continue rolling this and be back in a moment. I've rolled it out to a 12 by 12 inch square. So now I'm going to go ahead and cut these into 2 inch by 2 inch strips. You don't have to be super precise on this because it is going to go in the oven and bake after all. So if you're just a little off, that's fine. I'm going to turn it this way and do the same. And I always tend to get a little bit of an angle, but it'll all work out. You can see they're not perfect, but that's fine. So I'm going to go ahead and put these into the muffin cups, and I'm going to stretch them in a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and finish these. I've got all the little cups done, and I'm going to go ahead and prick them each just a couple of times. This is called docking. You do it when you do pizza dough also. And that's just so the cups don't puff up too much, because they're going to get par-baked and I need to have room to put the filling in, so I can't let them completely take over the pan. And then these are going to go into a 400 degree oven. Our puff pastry cups have baked and they're out of the oven. They were in there for only 6 minutes at 400 degrees. And I'm going to go ahead and just poke a little hole, a little well in each one so that we can get our filling in. As I said earlier, we also did not cook the chicken 100% because it's going to go in these and I don't want it to be overcooked when these come out. So we're just going to put a little spoonful in each one. It's a little messy because you're going to have to kind of shove it down in there. But these will be so worth it. So I'm going to go ahead and fill these up and be back in a moment. I've got the cups all filled, and one of the tips for this appetizer is you can actually make this ahead. You can make the filling the day before and keep it in the refrigerator. It'll actually improve in flavor. And then the little cups, you can bake them earlier in the day before the party. And then when your guests arrive, all you got to do is fill them up and bake them. And you have this elegant, delicious, satisfying appetizer that everybody's going to ooh and ah over. That was no work at all. And that's the point of these appetizers that we make for this party. Christmas, Thanksgiving, the holidays, they don't have to drive you crazy. You can simplify if you come up with a plan. So I'm gonna top each of these with just a sprinkle of our Parmesan, and then they're gonna go back in the oven again at 400 degrees and probably about 4 to 5 minutes, that's all, because they are pretty well baked and the chicken is pretty well cooked through. We just want to finish that off and also let all the flavors come together. And then another hint for your parties. When you do a series of appetizers, use different sorts of platters and use your cake stands. Get different heights on your buffet platter on your table, wherever you're going to put this all out. Change colors. You know, if you have a theme for your party, like ours was red and white, and we added touches of gold. So we just had different levels, bowls, cake stands, platters, and it looked absolutely fantastic. And it actually looked like more appetizer than was really out there. And then I just went back and filled them as the platters got emptied, which they did very quickly. So I'm going to put these in the oven and we'll take a look at them in 5 minutes. And there we have our beautiful chicken and shallot cups. These are fairly delicate. I would not recommend stacking them. So let the hardest thing you do at your holiday party be to refill your appetizer platters and bowls and enjoy your time with your friends.